Across America and around the world, you're listening to the Hour of the Time. And we're in real time now, folks. This is not a rerun. In fact, you won't be hearing any more reruns for some time now. I'm your host, William Cooper. Folks, I know that a lot of you out there have ordered audio tapes of past programs of the Hour of the Time. Now, as long as just a few of you were ordering audio tapes, it was no problem. We were duplicating them on a regular stereo tape deck with a high-speed dub, which meant for an hour's tape, it was taking us about 30 minutes to run off a tape. But now we've been overloaded with orders. There's no way possible that we can fill these orders with a stereo tape deck on high-speed dub. So we have ordered a Telex ACC-4000, which will duplicate three tapes in about 2 minutes or less. And as soon as we get that unit in, we'll be able to catch up with all of these back orders and get them shipped out to you. Until then, we ask that you be patient. And after that, we plan on having it set up so that when a tape order comes in, we will be able to ship the tape the following day without exceptions. So we're learning on this end, and we're getting some indication as to why Stan retired. We are so bogged down in mail and trying to answer that mail and orders and CAGI memberships and everything else. And folks, there's just me doing it. That's all. Only me now that Stan is retired. And like I said, I'm swamped. We're learning how to do it faster. As far as tape duplication goes, we've ordered a machine. And you guys better start ordering a lot of tapes, because that machine cost us $1,900. And it's going to take an awful lot of tapes just to pay for the machine before we ever make a nickel. And that's going to take quite some time. Well, in the meantime, while you're waiting for your tape, if you've ordered a tape, I would invite you, and I invite you now, to call Swiss America Trading. If you've been listening to this program, folks, for any length of time, you will know that I have been passing along information that indicates our country is in serious economic trouble. We are fast approaching a state of bankruptcy, and if the truth were known, we're already in it. The currency doesn't exist. And when this bankruptcy hits, when it's publicly acknowledged, that is, the money as we know it will cease to exist. It's that simple. For the next 200 callers, folks, you can receive a free copy of Harry Figge's report entitled Tackle the Debt. Tackle the Debt. In it, you will see for yourself just how bad our debt situation is, and you won't be hearing it from me. You'll be hearing it from a third party. And, by the way, Harry Figge is not connected with Swiss America Trading whatsoever. But knowing we are in trouble, folks, isn't good enough. You also need to know how to protect yourself. And that's why I recommend Swiss America Trading for non-confiscatable, non-reportable hard assets. And they have other forms of investments that we recommend. They have other forms of investments we don't recommend, and some we don't know anything about. So be sure and ask about all these different things when you call and talk to the people at Swiss America Trading. Call my friends at Swiss America Trading at 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. They will not only inform you with this free figure report to the first 200 callers, but will also show you how to protect your future. Call them at 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. And while you're at it, mention my name, William Cooper, and you will also receive a free newsletter on protecting your future. When the dust settles, folks, and the country is bankrupt, where will you stand? Will you be standing there holding worthless money, or will you have protected yourself through non-confiscatable, non-reportable hard assets that have proven themselves throughout history to be the number one premier method of saving and holding on to what you've spent your life earning? People have called Swiss America Trading and invested with them since they began sponsoring this program have already realized that they did the right thing. They have made substantial increases in the value of that investment, which means they are protecting their assets. If you've been watching the money market, you know that the dollar is going down. Descending, the value of the dollar is getting lower and lower. And as the value of the dollar gets lower and lower, the value of your assets gets lower and lower, depletes, disappears right in front of your eyes. Well, those who have already called Swiss America Trading have protected that amount that they've invested in hard assets. The choice is yours. Either you make the call or you don't. Either way, it doesn't cost you a thing. And if you decide to invest, you can join those who already have a smile upon their face. So the choice is yours. Call today, 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. Thank you. Remember, that's from a distance. Take a closer look, folks, and remember, God is watching us always. What you're going to hear now during this program is a speech that I gave in the International Ballroom of the Airport Hyatt Hotel in Los Angeles. The ballroom was filled to capacity, wall to wall, people standing around the walls and sitting in the aisles. This is one of the most important talks that I have ever given. And I challenge you, no matter what your belief, no matter what your religion, no matter where you're coming from, what race you are, or what you believe, I challenge you to listen to this talk, to weigh it in the balance of your conscience and against whatever religion that you practice, and prove me wrong.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am very happy to be here once again. Usually, the way these things transpire, someone calls me or writes me a letter or goes to an intermediary. I said, Bill, would you please come to this meeting or symposium or convention and give a talk on such and such a date? And this is usually several months into the future. So when this happens, I say yes or no or maybe or whatever, and we iron out whatever it takes to make it work. And they always want a subject for what I'm going to talk about several months down the line, and I always give them one based upon what's happening at that time, what I know at that time, and what I think is important to talk about at that time. Well, I got to tell you, this is one of the few times that that's ever worked, because usually by the time I get somewhere to speak, whatever topic I've chosen is either outdated, either doesn't need to be talked about, or there's something more important that needs to be discussed, must be discussed, and is very important that does get discussed. Well, this time several of those things happened, but they're right in line with what I said I was going to talk about, and I hope, I sincerely hope, ladies and gentlemen, that I have your undivided attention and that you will lend some serious consideration to what I'm going to talk to you about today. I remember when I first began to talk publicly about what I had seen in documents when I was attached to the Office of Naval Intelligence, a strange thing happened. As long as I agreed that we were being visited by extraterrestrial beings from outer space, and that these beings had entered into some kind of an illegal agreement with the United States government, as these documents that I had seen had stated, then I was pretty much welcomed and invited everywhere, and huge crowds come to talk to me. But a strange thing happened, folks. The very second that I began to equate extraterrestrials with New World Order, I came under the most vicious attacks that I have ever experienced in my life, anyone ever coming under for any reason. Now, this lent a tremendous amount of credibility to this connection, believe it or not. Totally adverse to what those who were doing the attacking wanted to happen. They wanted this connection not to be made. But it told me, because of the weight of the attacks, the severity of the attacks, the frequency of the attacks, that I was right on target. Right on target. And I made predictions based upon this, and based upon my research, and based upon other things that I had seen while I was in the Office of Naval Intelligence, and documents that I had uncovered, which led me to that connection. And I was called a conspiracy freak, a nut. And yet every single one of those predictions have come true. Not because I'm a prophet, not because I talk to God, because I can assure you that I don't, not because I'm a psychic or have any strange powers, but because I do an awful lot of studying. I'm an information freak. When I'm not talking to somebody or doing something else, my nose is in a book. I read so many books each week that sometimes I have to back off because all the information starts to mesh and I don't know where I got it from, and that becomes confusing to me. But the result has been that I am on the cutting edge right now of where we've been, where we're at, and what's coming down the road. And I am appalled that the rest of America is not on that cutting edge with me, because what's coming is not going to be anything that anyone in this room is going to like. Unless you're a bondage freak. And some of you may be. Now, I originally began to connect this with the secret societies of the world. And I wrote an entire chapter on my book, The Involvement of the Secret Societies in the New World Order. And I began forming an organization known as the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence, which has since become the largest and most successful intelligence gathering network under civilian control in the world, bar none. 2 years ago, we sent members out to infiltrate the secret societies and obtain the necessary degrees to reach a level where they would find out what was happening, really. Because the only thing we have access to is what they have written, and they never write the truth, because they are sworn by blood oath that they cannot divulge the truth of what they are really up to. Some prolific writers, if you understand the symbology and the esoteric language that they speak to each other, have revealed the truth, but only those who understand the symbology and the esoteric language can read it and understand it. One of those writers is Manly P. Hall. You people in L.A. have a tremendous opportunity, because the Philosophical Society, founded by Manly P. Hall, is right here. It has one of the biggest libraries on the occult, the secret societies, and the esoteric teachings of this secret religion that goes all the way back to the dawn of the history of man and the worship of the sun that exists on the face of this planet. And yet, most of you are chasing lights in the sky. And waiting for the benevolent space brothers to rescue you. Are debating whether a period or a comma or the day of the month comes first in a document which keeps you all spinning around in circles and cul-de-sacs at the whims of people like William Moore and Stanton T. Friedman, so that you never understand what's really happening in this world or who's bringing it about. And that's the real intent of all those silly little pathetic arguments. And when someone comes up and wants to present to you a different point of view, is the information discussed? Is there an intelligent argument or conversation or dialogue conducted about the merits of the points of the argument? No. Don't listen to that person, because he's a drunk. Folks, I know a lot of drunks. None of them are liars. Now, I'm trying to make a point here that is extremely important that you connect with. Well, I told you that the real purpose of my even ever discussing anything that I ever saw, or even trying to wake up anyone, was not to tell you about the reality or fantasy of extraterrestrial visitation to this earth, but was to wake you up to the reality of the imminent enslavement of the American people, the destruction of the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. The document, the only document in the history of the world that ever granted any man or woman that ever walked on this earth freedom. Ever. Blacks are being taught that the Constitution is not for them, because they were enslaved under the Constitution, and that's not true. You see, it was blacks in Africa who captured those blacks and sold them into slavery. And it was ship owners who were not American who carried those black slaves to these shores and sold them to the plantation owners. And it was white Americans who established the movement to free those black slaves, and it was the Constitution of the United States of America that allowed it to be done and gave them the freedom that they enjoy today. If At that time, they could not have been citizens of free states because state constitutions specified they had to be free white property owners. All of those constitutions have been changed, allowing anyone born in any state in this country to be a free sovereign citizen, a king or queen in their own right, in a state as a state citizen. Now, the reason I bring this up is to show how we're being manipulated. Black people are being manipulated to believe that they don't belong in this country, and it is a lie. And that's just one example. Many people are being used to hide the truth. Many, many people. There was a courier riding through Bavaria one dark night who was struck by lightning off of his horse. He was carrying dispatches from the Bavarian Illuminati to another lodge. In these dispatches, which were opened and handed over to the Bavarian government, were word-for-word passages taken from the protocols of the Elders of Zion. Yet the Jews have been used to cover this up and brand anyone who would dare publish this plan as anti-Semitic. I am the only one who's opened up this plan, had the guts to publish it, and have had the guts to say that Jews didn't write it, but Jews are being used to cover it up, just as blacks are being used to help foment rebellion in this country by making them feel that they don't belong here. One of the greatest machinations of these people in charge who are bringing about the New World Order to slave all humanity, doesn't matter who you are, is the method of pitting us against each other so that while we're running around weakening ourselves and destroying ourselves, fighting each other, they are very busy in the background enslaving us all. The common man or woman of any race, religion, or creed is not our enemy. They are people just like us. No matter what their skin color, no matter what their religion, no matter what language they speak, no matter where they live, the only thing that they really want out of life is to provide a safe, secure home for their family and for their children, enjoy the fruits of their labor, which they are entitled to, and have some modicum of a happy life. I don't believe that there's anyone who would challenge that. So then why do we spend most of our time trying to destroy it? No war was ever fought because the people wanted to go to war. It's because the leaders manipulated the people into thinking they had to go to war. We must mature. We must become kings and queens in our own right, not just say that we are. We must understand these things. We must stop hating each other. The answer for white Christian separatists, what's called identity Christian, is not a nation of whites here, next to a nation founded by Louis Farrakhan and the Islamic nation of just blacks, because on that border there will always be war. The answer is not a Jewish ghetto. The answer is not rejecting the rest of society's cultural mores, but yet demanding that a guest in your house wear the yarmulke if they're not of your faith. Now understand me, ladies and gentlemen, I am for one thing and one thing only. Truth first, humanity second. The truth is more important than anything. I don't care how much it hurts to hear it. It is the only reality that we can live by and ensure a comfortable future. And if the truth hurts and if the truth is bad, we can only make it better by acknowledging what the truth is and working for that better future together as humanity, not as blacks and whites. And tell me, folks, what the hell is an Afro-American? When I hear that, I know somebody's confused. Are you an African or are you an American? And I'm not trying to insult blacks. I understand that you are hungry for a history, for something to identify with. And I understand that hunger because my parents were in the military. I never had a hometown. I hunger with you. I don't have any place where I can go and say, that's the school I went to in the third grade, and old Mrs. Jones lives down there, and go say hello to her. I know what you're going through. I know that you feel like you don't have any roots, but you have to decide, are you African or are you American? Do you belong in the state of Israel or do you belong to America? Are you a German Aryan? If so, go to Germany! Or are you an American? It's funny that we have in this country the penultimate of the gifts of all the people who have ever lived upon this planet. And we're pissing on it. And it makes me sick. It's painful. Now let me give you some ideas as to what I'm talking about, folks. How many of you were in Waco, Texas? I was. I was in Waco, Texas because I knew from day one something was terribly wrong. Because I was watching my television set and here's what I saw. I saw a church under attack by federal forces. And it turned out to be the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. And then I heard the leader of the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms conduct a press conference where he said, this church has murdered 4 of our agents and wounded 16 more. And the reason that we're here is because a foreign source reported through the State Department that this church was going to commit mass suicide. You see, something in my head clicks because I understand the Constitution. I know what's happening. Most people don't. They're what I call sheeple, not people. What I heard is these people were accused of getting ready to commit mass suicide. The answer for this crime was to murder them all. We ain't having no mass suicide in this country. Kill them. Not only that, but we didn't have the suicide squad going there. We had the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms, a federal agency which has no jurisdiction over suicide in the state of Texas, whether or not they were really going to commit suicide. So I knew instantly they were lying to me. And if they were lying to me, I belonged in Waco, Texas, and I went. I have a radio show. Was broadcast worldwide on shortwave Monday through Friday night. If you don't have a shortwave radio, whether or not you ever listen to my show or not, you better get one, because it's the only way you're ever going to hear the truth of what's happening in this world. Because the media in this country is absolutely and totally 100% controlled. Because the media never questions any of this. This was not questioned by the media at all, was it? When the public started asking questions, and very few questions, and none of them were the right questions, what was the next thing we were told? These people were terrorists. We were told that they were terrorists.
Well, folks, you can hear that my voice had not healed when I made that speech. I hope that you can bear with it and understand what I'm saying despite the handicap. It's time to take our break now. Don't go away. We'll be right back after this very short pause. Tim Cooper for Swiss America Trading. Folks, if you've been listening to this program for any length of time, you will know that I've been passing along information that indicates our country is in serious economic trouble. We are fast approaching a state of bankruptcy. When the bankruptcy hits, the money as we know it will cease to exist. For the next 200 callers now, listen to me carefully, for the next 200 callers, you can receive a free copy of Harry Figge's report entitled Tackle the Debt. In it, you will see for yourself just how bad our debt situation is. But knowing we are in trouble isn't good enough. You also need to know how to protect yourself. That is why I recommend Swiss America Trading for non-confiscatable, non-reportable hard assets. Call our friends, and yes, they are our friends, folks, at Swiss America Trading at 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. 2646. They will not only inform you with this free Figgy report to the first 200 callers, but will also show you how to protect your future. Call the experts at 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. And while you're at it, mention my name, William Cooper, and you will also receive a free newsletter on protecting your future. When the dust settles and the country is bankrupt, where will you stand? Will you be standing there holding worthless money, or will you have protected yourself through non-confiscatable, non-reportable, hard assets? The choice, folks, is yours. Call today, 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. And you'll be glad that you did.
And unless you were in Waco, Texas, you never heard this on the news. There were elements of the British SAS were there. Interpol was there. The reconnaissance aircraft used to take the aerial photographs from the Branch Davidian Church were British photo reconnaissance aircraft. The FBI was there. Anti-terrorist urban guerrilla warfare teams of the Intelligence Support Activity of the Special Operations Division of the Department of Defense were there, called Delta. They used military equipment. And they told you that they were FBI agents driving M60 tanks, the state-of-the-art of the military machinery, completely run and controlled by computers. And they just took this guy for a spin and taught him how to operate it. Bullshit! What hurt me the most is the American people bought this scam. Then they were told that David Kress was a child molester and a child abuser. I went and talked to the local sheriff, folks, and here's what he told me. Here's what he told me. He said, we have thoroughly investigated the Church of Branch Davidian because certain elements of international organizations have been making accusations against them for years. We have found no substantiation or evidence to support any of those claims. At one point, Mr. Cooper, we confiscated every weapon owned by all of the members of the Church of Branch Davidian, and we had to return them because not one weapon was illegal. I went to the child welfare people in Waco, Texas, and asked them about child molestation and child abuse. They said that they had thoroughly investigated all of those charges and had found no substantiation or evidence whatsoever for any of those charges, that they had interviewed every single child who lived or was at the compound, found them all to be healthy. None of them demonstrated any of the psychological trauma or psychosis which normally results from child molestation or abuse, and none of it was pursued, because their investigation showed that it was a fantasy. Then you heard Janet Reno disclaim the original purpose of the raid, that they were going to commit mass suicide. She said in her press conference that the reason that the FBI and the ATF were at Branch Davidian was because rumors of allegations of child abuse. Again, not coming under the jurisdiction of the federal government, but is a local matter, which had already been investigated and decided had no substance. That's why I went to Waco, Texas, because I knew they were lying to me on TV, and I knew from past experience that's all I was going to hear on TV was lies. I mobilized my organization, and we had approximately 47 or 48 members of the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence in Waco, Texas, investigating. What we found out will make your blood run cold and chills go up and down your spine for weeks. We found that this was planned well in advance. Well in advance. Wasn't something that just happened. It was coordinated with two other planned activities. One was the publication of a series of stories attacking the Branch Davidians, which came out that Saturday morning, the day before the raid occurred. The second was they were already building the movie set in the state of Oklahoma, which you just saw on television, of the raid. The result had been decided in advance. The script was written, the set was being built, and you just saw the results of that. Why? Because they can't have a new world order if American citizens have guns. We can't have a new world order if American citizens have principles, ideals, and religious morals which they adhere to. That's why. And you can watch for more of this to happen in the future. Much, much more of it. And it is nothing less than terrorism, and it is meant for the sheeple to cow them into not resisting, into giving up their guns, into quitting their church, into dropping their morals. And I don't say that you have to belong to any specific church or any church at all or even be religious. But I will tell you this, and all of our forefathers said it. America will fail when America ceases to be good. When America ceases to be virtuous. And that is true. That is true. The Bilderberg Group decided that Clinton was going to be president, and I revealed that long before the election. I said, they have named Clinton as the next president. And I know the Bilderberg Group, and I know their power, which means he will be the next president. And I was right. But he could never have won Pat Buchanan, Bill Gates, and H. Ross Perot had not taken away the conservative votes. Because they are all New World Order people. H. Ross Perot owns EDS. EDS is developing the microcomputer biochip, which is going to be the implant. H. Ross Perot got his money from a start granted to him by David Rockefeller. This is easy to research, nothing difficult at all. None of it. And Bill Clinton is president. Rhodes Scholar. Remember the Round Table Group. Remember the Council on Foreign Relations and the Trilateral Commission. Draft Dodger. Spent time in the Soviet Union when no other American citizen was allowed to travel there. Socialist par excellence. The New World Order will be a totalitarian socialist state, ladies and gentlemen. If you doubt that, just keep watching what happens around you. Socialism sucks. Socialism. Socialism has never worked. Hitler was a socialist. Nazi means national socialism. Hitler's vision of the future world is what's coming. Socialists always use the intelligentsia to help bring them to power. And as soon as they are brought to power, the first people they kill is the intelligentsia. The teachers, the professors, the scientists, the doctors, the lawyers, the thinkers. Because once you see socialism in action, you cannot support it. And these people will be the first to find that out, even though idealistically they thought it was the answer for all of our problems. It never is. Socialism brings pain, murder, labor camps, slaves, poverty, deprivation. We will pretend to pay you, and you pretend to what? Nazis are not right-wing, irregardless of all these agent provocateurs who want to convince you otherwise. Socialism is left-wing, just one notch above communism. It is the marriage of the state and the corporation. Right-wing is less government. Stop falling for all the lies that you hear. If you're left-wing, if you're a liberal, if you're a socialist, if you're a communist, you are a Nazi! This has to be stopped. I could go on and on about Waco, Texas, and many other things. best be stopped by educating each other, by waking up. When you see these things happening, by joining me there. I didn't see anybody in this room in Waco, Texas. You should have been there with me. If there were enough of us just standing there, nothing would have happened. Nothing. And people would not be dead. Instead, what I heard, oh, they're just a bunch of religious lunatics that deserve to die. I got news for you. You're next. You're next. And there's a label that fits you that sounds just as nutty no matter who you are. Labels are easy to concoct. I have a computer at home. I can run out 5,000 labels in an hour and pin one on each of your chests. We'll get rid of everybody. New York police report plans for spot checks of citizens. Newspaper, New York Times. 12-4-92. I'm sorry, this comes from Gun Week, 12-4-92. Another scam. Ozone layer, ozone depletion, baloney. The whole human race doesn't produce enough CFCs to make a dent in the ozone layer, if there was one, which there's not, but volcanoes do. Remember when I made the prediction that United States troops would be put under foreign command and would fall under the jurisdiction and total command of the United Nations? Orange County Register, 42193. United States and Germany exchange command of thousands of each other's troops. U.S. troops under foreign commanders. The Orange County Register, Sunday, February 14th, 1993. What the hell do you think is happening in Somalia? What do you think Desert Storm was all about? They didn't give a damn if Saddam Hussein took Kuwait. But they did care about establishing the precedent in international law that the United Nations can pass a resolution, send a police force to enforce it, and make the members pay. And none of our troops wore United States insignia, and the United States of America was painted off of all of our equipment in Desert Storm. And I guarantee you, there is nobody in Somalia wearing the insignia of the United States of America on their uniforms or their equipment. Report, fatal raid on Malibu Ranch based on illegal warrant. Did you know when the BATF raided the Branch Davidian in Waco, Texas, they did not have a legal warrant, and they did not have a warrant that allowed no-knock raid? The warrant was not signed by a federal judge, it was signed by a magistrate. Arson investigator, investigating the arson at Branch Davidian in Waco, Texas. Orange County Register, 42793. Arson investigator has close federal ties. Arson investigator Paul Gray has close ties to the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. In fact, his wife is the secretary in the Houston office that planned the raid. The three people that Clinton appointed to oversee this arson investigator to make sure he did a good job were all present in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and are all three connected with the burning of the Move group. There's a pattern of burning. The Symbian Liberation Army was burned. The Move group was burned. Matthews in the state of Washington was burned. Randy Weaver was going to be burned, but two reporters stumbled upon the helicopter as they were attempting to raise the fuel bladder off the ground, and they were forced to abort the mission or admit their plans. Branch Davidian burned. FBI admits photos of Idaho shootout scene where the Randy Weaver family was destroyed were staged. For you medical people, you've just been hearing about mysterious deaths in the four corners of Arizona, Utah, Colorado, and New Mexico. People got upset. They started asking for answers, so they gave you one. Vaccine for rat droppings. Close I live. I know what you're at. I live in the state of Arizona. I have been there. I've investigated this. I've talked to all the doctors and researchers who are on this. When I began to press them about this virus and rat droppings, they looked a little sheepish. When I insisted upon an answer, not one of them could show me any proof, any indications, any evidence, or would admit that any one of them were the ones who came up with it. Because it ain't true. They have no answer. They don't know, period. They don't know. But I do. Colds, flu, why do we have to suffer with this stuff? Every year, thousands of older people die because of colds and flu. All the way back, folks, and this is dated April 1969. Bacterial vaccine and viral vaccine, mixed respiratory for colds and flu. Three people were vaccinated with this. Those three people have never had a cold or the flu since. Yet, this is not given to the public. This is an actual photograph of the label in the bottle, the literature from the drug company, and it's Hollister Steer Laboratories, Los Angeles, California. Sure, cold, flu, withdrawn from the public, not allowed for the public. Now the same thing that's happening in the Four Corners is happening right here, folks. I wrote about my book, told you a long time ago. There's a chemical called parathion, which is found in the following: chlorothion, dimethon, diazinon, diptorex, HETP, malathion, nerve gas for chemical warfare, OMPA, cystox, TEPP. Let me read you the symptoms. Nausea, vomiting, abdominal cramping, excessive salivation, increased pulmonary secretion. Drown in your own lungs with your own fluids. Headache, rhinorrhea, blurred vision, meiosis, slurred speech, mental confusion, breathing difficulty, frothing at mouth, coma. Note, mental confusion. Absorbed through skin. And the next time a helicopter flies over your house spraying malathion and you don't shoot it down, you're a fool. This is taken from the Merck Manual, 15th edition. A manual normally only seen by physicians. And let me ask you this, folks. Why is it called the Centers for Disease Control? Why not the Center for Disease Eradication? I'm going to be conducting a workshop, folks. It's 4:15. It is important that you attend this workshop. I'm not going to talk about what I just talked about. Instead, I'm going to show you the real Zapruder film that you have never seen. I'm going to prove to you that Robert Groden is a liar and has been lying for his entire career. I'm going to prove to you that Oliver Stone lied to you in his movie JFK. I'm going to show you the missing footage that all of these people have censored and cut out and that you've not been allowed to see since Kennedy was assassinated and you couldn't have ever seen unless you were there watching the motorcade. It is in crystal clear, brilliant color. It is from a first-generation copy of the Zapruder film on 35mm. We put it on the Rank Centel in Dallas, Texas. We have computer analyzed it. We have blown it up frame by frame. You're going to see what's really in Dealey Plaza that no one has ever shown you before. And I'm going to tell you the real reason why Kennedy was killed, which has nothing whatsoever to do with Vietnam or the Federal Reserve. Has to do with letting this black man in this room today and this black lady sitting here with all us white folks Kennedy was changing something that he wasn't supposed to change. He was attacking the secret societies at their very heart and soul, because they're all racist. Yes, they have black Masonic lodges called the Prince Hall Lodges, and white Masons can go to the Prince Hall Lodge, but you'll never see a black man in a white Masonic lodge. The Freemasons established this country, own it and control it, along with the other secret societies that go by different names but have the exact same structural pyramid of organization, where there's a whole bunch of slathering idiots at the bottom thirsting after the secret so they'll never know a damn thing, with a few at the top controlling everything. They are Aryan. They are racist. It has always been their goal to create a new world order. They put Novus Ordo Seclorum on our dollar bill. They are the direct descendants of the Knights Templar. They were the first international bankers, and they are still the international bankers. And in their estimation, folks, quote, a nation, a world of people who will not use their intelligence are no better than animals who do not have intelligence. Such people are beasts of burden and stakes on the table by choice and consent. These people are Nazi. And unless you wake up, you are sheeple. All sheep are sheared and then eventually led to the slaughter. And I challenge you, prove me wrong. If you listen to my radio broadcast, you've already heard 23 hours of exposure of the mystery schools and their control, where we've been, where we're at, and where we're headed. Where we're headed is the destruction of all independent nation states on this globe, the destruction of all religions on this globe, save theirs. And being an atheist won't help you, because unless you bow down to their God, they're going to get rid of you too. And the enslavement of the sheeple. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I hope to see you at 4:15.
Well, folks, I hope that brings some of the real issues home and dumps them right into your lap. Now, if you're one of these people that seriously thinks that sometime in the future you're going to create an all-black state or an all-white state, or you're going to confine all the Orientals to one continent or one peninsula or one island, let me tell you right now, you're dreaming, and that kind of an attitude is only going to bring on, ultimately, the worst war that's ever been fought on this earth, and it will be fought amongst the races. This kind of thinking must stop now. Good night, and God bless you all.
Country road on the wind, it comes to call. And it sings in the farms and the factory towns, and where you think there'd be no song at all. And the words are the words that our fathers said as they whistled down the years. And the name of the song is the name of the tree, and it's music to our ears. America, America. And the dream goes on. America, America. And the dream goes on. The words that we read on the courthouse walls are the words that make us free. And the more we remember, remember the way we began, the closer we get to the best we can be. Was ever a time we forgot its worth, all the troubles and the scars? If we lead to the shield in the sky full of hope, and the flag is filled with stars. America, America, and the dream of as long as the music is strong and clear, that tomorrow will always